Let us attain. Wisdom. Sophia proshomen.
In those days, when the apostles were scattered because of the tribulation that arose over Stephen, they traveled as far as Phoenicia and Cyprus and Antioch, speaking the word to no one except to Jews only. But there were some of them, men of Cyprus and Cyrene, who upon coming to Antioch spoke to the Hellenists, also preaching the Lord Jesus. And the hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number that believed turned to the Lord. The report concerning them reached the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent out Barnabas to go as far out as Antioch. When he came and saw the grace of God, he was glad, and he exhorted to them all that with purpose of heart they should cleave to the Lord, for he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and faith, and a great multitude was added unto the Lord. Then Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year they were gathered together in the church and taught a great multitude of people, and disciples were called Christians first in Antioch. Now in these days, prophets came down from Jerusalem to Antioch, and one of them, named Agabus, stood up and signified by the Spirit that there would be a great famine over the whole world. And this took place in the days of Claudius Caesar, and the disciples, everyone according to his ability, determined to send relief to the brethren who dwelt in Judea. And they did so, sending it to the elders by the hand of Barnabas and Saul.
Peace be to thee, he that readeth.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom attend, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be to all. The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend. At that time, Jesus came to a city of Samaria called Sychar, near the field that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and so Jesus, tired as he was with his journey, sat down beside the well. It was about the sixth hour. There came a woman from Samaria to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink," for his disciples had gone away into the city to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How is it that you, a Jew, ask a drink of me, a woman of Samaria? For Jews have no dealings with Samaritans." Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God, and he it is that is saying to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. Where do you get that living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well and drank from it himself, and his sons and his cattle?" Jesus said to her, "Everyone who drinks of this water will thirst again, but whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst. The water that I shall give him will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water, that I may not thirst nor come here to draw." Jesus said to her, "Go and call your husband and come here." The woman answered him, "I have no husband." Jesus said to her, "You are right in saying, 'I have no husband,' for you have had five husbands, and he who you are now living is not your husband. This you truly said." The woman said to her, "Sir, I perceive that you are a prophet. Our fathers worshipped on this mountain, and you say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Jesus said to her, "Woman, believe me, the hour is coming when neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem will you worship the Father. You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for such the Father seeks to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth." The woman said to him, "I know that the Messiah is coming, he who is called the Christ. When he comes, he will tell us all things." And Jesus said to her, "I who speak to you am he." Just then his disciples came. They marveled that he was talking with a woman, but none said, "What do you wish?" or "Why are you talking with her?" So the woman left her water jar and went away into the city and said to the people, "Come see a man who said to me all that I ever did. Can this be the Christ?" They went out to the city and were coming to him. Meanwhile, the disciples besought him, saying, "Rabbi, eat." But he said to them, "I have food to eat of which you do not know." So the disciples said to one another, "Has anyone brought him food?" And Jesus said to them, "My food is to do the will of him who sent me and to accomplish his work. Do you not say there are yet four months, then comes the harvest? I tell you, lift up your eyes and see how the fields are already white for harvest. He who reaps receives wages and gathers fruit for eternal life, so that sower and reaper may rejoice together. For here the saying holds true, one sows and another reaps. I sent you to reap that for which you did not labor. Others have labored, and you have entered into their labor." Many Samaritans from that city believed in him because the woman's testimony, "He said to me all that I ever did." So when the Samaritans came to him, they asked him to stay with them, and he stayed there for 2 days. And many more believed because of his words. They said to the woman, "It is no longer because of your words that we believe, for we have heard for ourselves. And we know that this is indeed the Christ, the Savior of the world."